came in homeless, defeated, broken, and who now is a prayer warrior, powerful in the Word of God.
My name is Reginald Grigsby. I'm originally from Nashville, Tennessee. I've been here in Florida since 99. I'm a member of Christian Leadership Institute. I praise Pastor Princess because one day she walked up to me and asked me if I knew Jesus. And I told her I thought I did, and she said that wasn't good enough. I first come here, Pastor Princess actually let me sleep outside in the back here. I had a sleeping bag, pillow, couple of blankets that she had given me because we was not able to sleep nowhere else at the time. And then eventually she opened up the doors where we can come inside and sleep, which is where I met God. I have to say I met God here because I'd never seen nobody with that type of love for somebody that she didn't even know. Yet it wasn't just myself, it was someone else with me. And she embraced us. She didn't care about how we smelt or how we looked, or it was more about what we knew about God. And the more I invested in hearing what she had to say, the more closer I got to God, to eventually I gave my life to God. I graduated from special education, and I had a first grade level. My walk has been a crazy walk. Come from a foster home, but from a church-going family. My foster parents ended up being my kinfolk. I was blessed to be able to see my dad and mom every day, but I didn't know that they were my dad and mom. I thought that was my uncle and auntie. And who I was staying with that was my foster parents is actually my cousins. It was kind of hard, but other than that, I say they were wonderful people. I'm a sibling with a lot of sisters and brothers. My real mom and dad was having kids, but my cousin then was taking them in. So, you know, it's 25 of us all together. I was a drug dealer in my hometown, as well as running around having a lot of kids. I ended up homeless. And I ended up sleeping in, that was a place called Williams Park here, where a lot of homeless people went to sleep. Then I'd find a car somewhere, or a truck, or abandoned house. Or there have been a lot of cases where I slept behind bushes. And one day, somebody died in the family, and they left me a lot of money. I was also a user, too. I was what they call a working addict, a functional addict is what they call it. I ended up in two towns over from where I originally lived, and I didn't know that I'd been in that hotel for over 2 weeks. So when I came to myself, I took a shower and I told God that, you know this is not it for me. This is not what you created me into this world to be, was an addict or a dope dealer. If you don't take it away from me, you know, I'm going to be dead.
Minister Ray came into the ministry with a calling. That caller was to speak and preach God's word to a population that he had been involved with.
That was a lot of, I want to say, fights at the beginning. For everything she had to say to me, I had a rebuttal for it.
Whatever it was, he could quote it from the King James Version. But he had no idea. You know, and I always tell him, well, that sounds good, but it doesn't go with that. It sounds good. What does it mean? CLI taught him that. Definitely. CLI, the Holy Spirit. And that's a dogged determination. Because there were times he didn't have Wi-Fi. There were times he did not have, he might have had a phone, but he didn't really have energy to invest that time in it, and he would do it anyway. He started over things over and over again, but he's been very persistent in it. I like the interactive nature of how CLI works. It's a forgiving institute. I put it that way. Most schools, you pay, you don't finish the class in a certain number of time, you're done. Three times, you're out. This you can continue on. If you're not done within the amount of time, then you start over. And sometimes that's just best.
She introduced me to Christian Leadership Institute, and oh boy, it's first, it was just like, what? But letting go and letting God, that got me, you know, to understand what diaconess is, which I had a long time trying to learn how to pronounce that word. But to know what diaconess is, and so much more in the Bible, it's precious. It's precious to those that want to hold it and give it away, give it back. And that's what CLI has done for me, and that's what Pastor has done for me. She's my best friend.
With CLI, you can get free ministry training. There's no obstacle. You just need to be committed and focused. If Ray can do it, if Ray can come up here, stand up here, go out, and people are attracted to the word, literally the word, the humility, the gentleness, the kindness. The fruit of the Spirit is in full operation. If it can work for him, it can work for anybody that is called by God to be in this ministry.